I'm going to be talking about another method that we have implemented for modifying the model. So the method that we are that we've implemented we are referring to as a contour-based approach. What we're doing in this method is that for each body part, we're going to define section of the body which we are calling as contours. Okay, so the contours are essentially closed, non-intersecting curves like circles or ellipses, which are defined on every body region. For example, if I'm talking of the arm, it's going to be a series of closed curves on the arm. Those will be defined, of course, automatically. The user does not have to define them, but that is what is going to form the core of the method. Like in the previous method, we are using control points on the body. In this method, we are using contours, which are typically closed curves. Some of them are open curves, but typically they're closed curves on the body. So the process that we're following, there are the four steps that are done. Of course, the user does not have to explicitly carry out these steps, but it'll be good for you to understand what we're doing. First, of course, we are creating the contours dynamically using what we are calling as a contour CL, which is the control line or a skeletal structure which is defined inside the body. Okay. Then, of course, we do modification of the contours. The contours are modified, they are scaled according to the data that is available either through an interactive method or through the targets which have been defined earlier. Then we do something called Delaunay-based mapping, in which the volume of the body, the space of the body inside the skin, is mapped into a set of tetrahedrons using a Delaunay triangulation approach. And then after the modification of the contours, we do a remapping and modify the complete mesh. So I'll just demonstrate what we are doing. What you see in this figure here, on the left side, the yellow line that you're seeing, these are what we are referring to as a skeletal structure inside the body. We refer to it as the contour CL or the contour control line. Now, this is defined internally. This is a metadata which is available for the body, which is being provided along with the Piper tool. And using this contour CL, these are the contours which are generated automatically. So these are the closed curves that I talked about. On the whole body, you'll find these closed curves being generated. And these form the key of our approach, because this is what is used subsequently in the next step. So if you look at these slides, what we're doing is, this is of course the initial body. We are defining these contours. These contours are modified based on inputs which are going to be given by the user. So for instance, what you see in this table, I just show a small video which will demonstrate what I'm talking about. These are the different different targets which are defined. These are the initial values of those of these parameters. These are the final values which have been read from those from the target file. And the model is going to be modified as per these dimensions. And this is going to be the finally modified model that will be generated. I'll just run a video to explain this. Okay, so we have. So we're starting with the model right now. We open the contour personalization window. Okay, and we go into target personalization. So we first have to load the contour control file, which, okay. So once the contour control file is loaded, after that we are able to generate the contours. You see these contours being generated. And then we are loading the target file. And now this is the target file which has been made earlier by the method that has been described by the previous speakers. Yeah, so once I load this target file, you'll notice that these values have all got populated now. Okay, these are the initial values, these are the initial dimensions which are there in the original model. These are the target dimensions which have been given to it by the target file that has been opened. Okay, so we preview what changes are expected. You see the change in the contours over here. We can reset it if we don't like it. Okay. We can go back and see what are the changes being done. In fact, one thing I'll mention here, Yeah, that's. So this. So I've. Maybe I'll. So the contour display has been turned off. The model has been personalized according to the data, according to the dimension that were given. Of course, in this case, you would see that abnormal dimensions have been given. That is because we just wanted to display what is happening, so the dimensions were given in that manner. The other thing that you would notice is that the bones have also got expanded accordingly. That is because the option for not scaling the bones proportionally has been suppressed at the moment. Okay, but that can in the final version that will be there, so that the bones. I mean, if you don't want to scale up the bones accordingly, you will have the option of suppressing that option. Okay, so this is how the scaling has been done for the body. You can load the target file, go through this process, and scale the. In fact, what you would notice that in this particular case, the arms have been extended, okay, beyond what they were earlier. That is a part of the value that were given in the target. Okay. So this is again, we're loading the contour CL, generating the contours. Okay, now if you look at this step, a list of contours is being shown over here. We can also pick up a list of length parameters over here, and then here we can select any of the parameter that we want to alter and change and scale it locally at that position, even if we have not got a target file and we want to do it directly from here. So that option is also available, so that we can change portions selectively the way we want to do it. Okay. So we make one change. So we've changed just one parameter here. We change one contour, and accordingly the body was personalized or modified in locally in that particular region. Okay. We can also change the length parameters. For example, we're taking the right arm, we are modifying the length of the right arm. Okay. We personalize that, and you would notice that here the length of the right arm has been increased. It's longer than the left arm, and the portion ahead of the elbow has been moved forward accordingly. Okay.